Welcome to the Dan and Cody Podcast.
This is the Dan and Cody Podcast.
A toy boat. Toy boat.
The arsonist had oddly shaped feet.
This is the Dan and Cody Podcast.
Red yellow, red leather, yellow leather.
Saddle up, partner.
Hey, welcome to the Dan and Cody Podcast. Before we get started today, we have a word from our new, awesome, magnificent sponsor.
Are you or someone you know engaged to be married? Your wedding is the one time in your life when all of your friends and family come from far and wide to celebrate you and your future spouse. There's only one question. Where are all of your out-of-town loved ones going to stay over your wedding weekend? That's where JC Roomblocks comes in. Hi, I'm Jenny Hill, co-owner of JC Roomblocks. We set up hotel room blocks for weddings and special events nationwide. For a small one-time fee, we do all of the hard work for you. As certified travel agents, we are able to obtain the lowest possible hotel room rates, plus perks, freebies, and extras for you. For a limited time only, we are offering our services at the super low rate of just $20. That's right. For just a one-time fee of $20, we can set up your wedding room blocks from start to finish. To get started, simply visit jcroomblocks.com or call 818-406-2351. Worry less, save more with JC Roomblocks.
What's that number again?
818-406-2351.
JCRoomBlocks.com. Today, we have a substitute co-host, Ryan Albertson, my dear friend and co-worker and very talented writer, CSUN graduate.
I do have a college degree.
I really do. He's college degreed. He's the man. What's up, yo?
How's it going?
It's good.
Thanks for having me, man.
It's weird seeing somebody that's not Cody right here.
I bet it's weird not seeing Matt. I normally am used to podcasting with Matt.
Like
my co-host. I understand.
That's right. You have a new podcast that has just dropped their first episode, correct?
Yeah, we came out on December 1st, Tuesday.
On a Tuesday.
Uh-huh. We're dropping 3 episodes that week. I'm not sure when this episode's coming out that we're currently recording.
Just soon.
Yeah, soon. Our episodes are probably up. Our podcast is called Lois and Clarked, the new podcast of Superman.
Find us
on iTunes.
Dope.
Like us on Facebook.
And what kind of podcast is it? Is it just...
We're a rewatch podcast. Yeah, so we are basically going through Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman, starring Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher.
Right.
Created by Deborah Joy Levine.
I would so do Terry Hatcher.
DT-dubs. One of the best parts is Terry Hatcher.
Just marveling
just
at her?
Just visually.
See, I couldn't do that podcast because, like, Matt, your co-host, would be talking about it, and then I'd just be like, dude, did you see her boobs in that shot?
We go there.
You go there?
It's necessary sometimes.
Oh, that's good.
There's this one episode where she goes back to Smallville with Clark, and she's just wearing this dress that's just like, it's just good. It's just good. You get it all. You get everything you'd ever want.
She's got her cookies on display.
Oh yeah, and there's like running around and stuff. So it's pleasant.
I'm excited for it. I had the pleasure of getting a sneak peek of episode 1.
Oh yeah, we let you listen to it. That's right.
Yeah, it was really fun. It's a really cool podcast. If anyone, these kind of podcasts are awesome because even if you haven't seen a show, or if you love the show. You listen to these podcasts and these guys break it down for you and it makes you either want to watch the show or it validates all of your questions that you had about the show.
Yeah. And let's be honest, Lois and Clark is 80% batshit insane. It is out of control.
Like all I know of it is Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher. That's it.
I mean, that's the real takeaway is Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher.
That's it.
I mean, that's the start of Dean Cain's acting career, however short-lived. May it rest in peace. Actually, no, he's on Supergirl now. Congrats to him.
I think he's on life support at this point. At career-wise.
Yeah, I mean, he might. I mean, will he? I doubt he'll make, like, a resurgence, but I'm sure he's doing fine.
I saw him on a random TV movie where he, like, no, not that, that was,
That Holiday in Handcuffs?
No, that's not, that's Mario Lopez.
Oh gosh.
Yeah.
They're easy to mix up. They look very similar.
That's Mario Lopez and, what's her name? Clarissa Explains It All.
Oh,
Melissa Joan Hart.
Yeah, yeah.
But Dean Cain, he was on this fucking really shitty TV movie where he, like, spoiler alert, he turns out to be, like, the bad guy.
Oh, no.
And he's shooting, oh, Brittany Murphy. He's, like, killing, he's, like, chasing around dead Brittany Murphy.
Wait, there's a movie that exists with Brittany Murphy and Dean Cain.
Yes. Yes.
And I haven't seen
it. It's not like Lifetime or Hallmark.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it doesn't matter that it's on Lifetime or Hallmark. I'm disappointed that I haven't seen it.
Yeah, it is bad. Let me see if I can find it really
quick.
Look
it up. Get it. Yeah, it's a lot of fun doing a rewatch podcast, though, because, you know, I've never watched the show myself until Matt kind of suckered me into it. And
so you're like the novice, and he's the
initiated.
The initiated.
Sure.
The guru.
I'd say more like, you know, I'm the straight man, and he's out of his mind.
Right.
No, not really. But yeah, he's kind of a Superman expert. He knows a lot about superheroes and a lot of the DC mythos, and I don't know any of that shit. So.
Yeah, he is super, super DC comic guy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's aggressive. It's a little aggressive.
I mean, all of our advertising pictures is we're just using things he already owned. Like, no, there were no purchases made there.
He's already planned out how this is going to go in his head for, like, years and years.
He's like, oh, I just so happen to have a Lois and Clark crew jacket. I just happen to have that. We should use it.
And that's,
like,
insane.
Yeah, we should. Where? What?
It's like, how long have you been planning this podcast, bro? It's on, like, his timeline of bucket lists. Lois and Clark
podcast. Lois and Clark podcast. Actually, truthfully, he really wants to, write a conclusion season as a comic. That's actually a goal of his. That's
a
one
conclusion.
Of the,
oh, what? Because it's like
of
a hiatus.
The series. Yeah, I mean, I haven't gotten that far. I've only watched half of the first season at this point.
Right.
So I don't really know how it ends, but maybe not satisfying.
Hmm.
Yeah, because he's expressed, like, I really want to write a comic for another season.
That's,
and I'm like,
really,
oh, that's
cool.
That's cool.
That's cool. That's ambitious, but cool.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, Matt's an ambitious guy. His comic is pretty good that he wrote.
Yeah.
Dark Ages.
Dark
everybody.
Ages, yo. Instagram them, Twitter them.
I just realized this is probably, like, already the most nerdy podcast you guys have done.
No.
God damn it.
Nope.
We've covered some pretty nerdy shit on here.
Let me just tell you, I've, not even close.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, not even close, man.
But I know you guys like sports stuff.
We like,
right?
Sports stuff. How many have you listened to? We try to stay away from,
I think,
sports.
I've done like 12. Oh, that's right. Good. Yeah, we talked about that.
We did sports on episode 2, and then anyone who texted me and stuff, they're like, dude, that happened like a long time ago. You shouldn't talk about sports.
Or, yeah. Unless
you lost me at sports.
Yeah, either it's nerds, like, hate it, or your the time between recording and putting your episodes out is too distant to maintain it. Sure.
The sporties they're mad at us, and then the non sporties are mad at us too. I can't find that movie with Dean Cain, by the way.
Oh, man.
It's like mixed in with, he's in a lot of movies with animals as the main character. It's ridiculous.
Well, I mean,
just going through this. Listen to some of these. All right. And a lot of Christmas. He's in the Dog Who Saved Easter. Small Town Santa. The Three Dog-a-Tears.
The Three Dog-a-Tears. What?
Horse Camp.
Oh, Horse Camp is very good.
Horse Camp. The Dog Who Saved Summer. That's likely a sequel to The Dog Who Saved Easter.
Does he have any other credits on these? Like, I'm kind of suspicious he might have written every single one of those.
He's in post for A Dog for Christmas. That's coming out this year.
Oh, jeez.
Like, fucking kill me, dude. You were Superman.
He's doing it for the kids. You know, he's got kids. You know, a lot of people who are really big. You know, once they have the kids, then they start making things like Star Wars Episode 2 or
this
whatever.
Poor guy. Oh, The Dog Who Saved Christmas Vacation. That came out before The Dog Who Saved Christmas.
That sounds more like the sequel to The Dog Who Saved Christmas. I feel like those came out in the wrong order.
Oh, my God. Just pet movie after pet movie. It's Like, how do you get typecast as the guy in pet movies?
I mean, to be fair, it might be, you know, they need someone who
works well with pets.
Works well with animals. And maybe like a dog acting with Dean Cain's acting, like, levels it all out.
Yeah.
You should cut that out. I'm not allowed to allowed to talk bad about Dean Cain on my podcast.
Oh, it's okay. We love you, Dean Cain.
We really do. We really do. But I mean, you were a football player first.
Let's speak Dean Cain's language.
Does he have any cat movies? I can't do any other animal noises but cat noises.
Oh, you know what his first movie was? Second movie, 1979. Dean Cain stars as Joe in Charlie and the Talking Buzzard. Joe! God bless him.
Good man.
Someone's got to be in.
He's got a great
movies.
Smile. His smile is out of control.
Oh, he's cute too. Jenny's mom loves him.
Oh yeah,
she really does.
Loves him.
I don't think she would. I don't think she's the only one.
Yeah, I mean,
that might be a thing.
He's an attractive dude as far as Superman. You know, like he did kind of fit the. I mean, I've never seen the fucking show, but like the promo stuff, he looks like Superman.
Yeah, I mean, he's to a lot of people, he is Superman. Matt was telling me that, like, that's the Superman he grew up with.
That's their guy.
Yeah, and so it's just when they think of Superman, they think of Dean Cain.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember seeing an I Love Lucy episode where Superman, like, comes to little Ricky's birthday.
Oh,
and
nice.
I was like, who the fuck is that guy? That's not Superman. But that's some. Those are
was
those.
Was he buff
people.
Enough, or did he just look weird?
Oh, he was buff, but mine was Christopher Reeve.
Oh,
you know?
Sure.
And apparently, not even Christopher Reeve is the Ridge.
No, there was George Reeves, I think was his name.
Oh,
not related. Not Christopher Reeve, and then there's George Reeves, who was the original Superman. They did a serial television show in like the 50s or 60s.
Well, I bet that's the guy. He was the first. I Love Lucy.
I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah, that makes sense because that was around the same era.
And Ricky Ricardo would always say, Superman. That's all I remember. Superman.
Excellent. I was watching I Love Lucy for the first time in like 8 years.
It's a good
couple
show.
Days ago. I love it. It's just charming and wholesome. And hilarious. Lucy reminds me of my sister. So, like, there's a nostalgia to it, like, on another level. Oh,
yeah.
It's great.
Why didn't Ed and Ethel get divorced?
They were not happy.
They were not a happy couple. They should have.
I will admit, they remind me of my grandparents, though. Like, that is the relationship that my grandparents have.
They're so
no,
angry.
No joke. At Thanksgiving dinner this weekend, my grandma is like, I'm cold. Like, can I turn the, will you turn? This is so ridiculous. She asked my grandpa to turn the fireplace on, and he's just like, it doesn't heat the whole room, Sharon. Like, if you want me to turn it on, you're going to have to come stand over here. Just put a jacket on. She's like, I don't have a jacket. And just like, dinner.
For Christ's sake.
And then he turns it on, and it totally heats the whole room. And
that's glorious.
He like tried to avoid the topic after that. It was pretty funny.
That's awesome.
Good old Grandpa Anderson.
So I gotta give a shout out to my homeboy. He's a good friend of mine, one of my fraternity brothers in Frostburg, named Jake Belts, and he's in Saudi Arabia, like, working.
Oh, that's your Saudi guy.
Yeah.
You're telling me about
that.
Well,
I'm not really sure what he actually does in Saudi Arabia. I just know he's there, but...
You probably don't want to know.
I don't want to know why he's there. But, he went out there a few years ago. But he had to come out to L.A. first to, like, shit in a cup. And he was like...
As one does.
Yeah. Like, he calls me and he's like, yo, what's up, Dan? I'm coming out to L.A. You want to hang out, get some beers before I go to Saudi? And I was like, yeah, okay. What the fuck are you doing in Saudi Arabia? He's like, well, you know, just stuff.
Nice.
Like, okay, great. And he's like, but I'm in Pasadena because I got to shit in this cup. And then they test that and then I can go. It's like, that's like your final step of going to Saudi Arabia. You got to crap in a cup.
What are they testing? Like drugs? Is there a shit drug test?
I don't know.
I doubt it.
I guess to work for this company, they really, They need your fecal matter.
That's crazy.
They need it.
They're like, look, we don't want you shitting anywhere in Saudi Arabia, so just know that if you fucking shit somewhere in Saudi Arabia, we're going to fucking find you, because we have that shit on file. All right?
We will find your
We're fucking watching.
This whole place is a fucking kitty litter box. We will find your shit and match it.
I think Saudi Arabia has got to be a beautiful place and probably not a kitty litter box.
It's probably great.
I had a Saudi friend who lived with me, not with me, but on my hall when I was going to college.
Yeah.
His name was Sajat.
Sajat.
He was awesome. We'd get super stoned together all the time.
Nice.
And every time, I never trusted him. Not because he was Saudi, but because he was just kind of sketchy. And so every time we'd hang out, I'd always ask him if he was a cop. So that became our like bit.
No.
Sajat, okay. are you a cop? And he'd never say no. So, like, I'm still not sure if he was a cop or not.
Do I look like a cop?
He was super sweet, though, and he would teach us how to say things in Arabic, or whatever Saudis speak. I hope it's Arabic, because I'm going to sound like an idiot otherwise.
Yeah, why not?
But he told me how to tell someone I'd shave their mustache, which is, Shenabekta halaholak.
That's it.
And that's how you say your mustache. I will shave that mustache.
All right.
I love it.
That's awesome you held on to that.
Yeah, I don't know how. I haven't said that in probably like several years.
That's very cool. Mm-hmm. But Bellis is out there and I have these, like, I'm able to like read the stats of like who's listening to the podcast. And we got two from Saudi Arabia.
Oh, nice.
One guy tweeted me, and so I guess that's the guy who was listening. And then Jake and his boy, Adil Akbar, wanted to say what's up to them because they're just chilling in Saudi Arabia.
What's up, guys?
Listen to the podcast. Congrats, Adil. Your wife's knocked up with twins.
Boom.
Boom.
Attaboy.
Your life's going to fucking change, bruv.
That's what I'm talking about.
You're screwed.
Sounds like some potent sperm going on there.
Yep. He's probably drinking that. Is there a kid? All right. I talked about this on another podcast, but dude had, he tweeted me a picture of camel urine in a can, like an energy drink that they sell in Saudi Arabia, and it apparently like helps you.
Oh, helps you be virulent.
Yeah, it helps you be strong. It like cures you of disease,
and it makes your dick hard.
Camel piss.
Nice.
It'll get you drunk.
That's crazy. It's is it boozy? I assume, or is it like an energy drink?
It's like, it's just like a health drink.
Okay, okay.
And I, yeah, it's like,
do you think it's legitimately camel piss? Because
I mean, probably.
I'm interested.
I know if you pee on a jellyfish sting, it'll go away.
So I mean, if you pee into your stomach, that bad stuff will go away. Right? That's how that works.
I'm glad we're getting all this out, because Cody hates talking about pee and poop. So
what?
We've already done both of those.
I wonder why. Does he pee or poop? Is he able to?
I don't know.
I've met two or three people who can't pee or poo, and you know, they're always the same, you know, kind of pale skinned.
Yeah.
Funny, but they have that look in their eyes like I still have never shat. It's,
you can tell they're not.
I'm freaked out by shit because I haven't done it.
They're non-shit virgin. They're shit virgins.
Shit virgins. Well, we'll have to pop the cherry on him.
Dude,
let him know I'm coming for him.
There's this,
I'm shaking my head, asking myself what the fuck I'm saying right now.
There was this this funny article I read on Esquire about this mom who she went down to like the downstairs bathroom that her son always uses, and on there, are you familiar with like what a fleshlight is? Yeah?
Yeah, no, I know what a fleshlight is.
You're laughing like, oh, I never. No. What?
No. No, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
What's up? Well, you guys know about Tenga eggs?
I know about Tenga eggs. Tenga eggs.
Look it up.
Okay. Tenga eggs.
We can talk about that later. Go on.
So this mom took a picture of this apparatus that is attached at like waist level to the wall of the shower. And it's protruding. For all of you who do not know what a fleshlight is, this is a device that looks like a flashlight when hidden, like in its natural state. But you pop off the cap, which would be like where the light is, and it's a sweet little vagina.
Little silicone pussy.
Little silicone poontang.
Mm-hmm. And that's right, I said pussy.
You can.
Get over it.
You can do that. You can do that on the Dan and Cody podcast.
I love this podcast.
But So
I never get to say pussy on my podcast.
You can't say it enough. It's
a running conversation that me and Matt are having. I'm working on it.
Just get it. Pussy.
Yeah, pussy. Anyway.
Mom don't want to listen to this.
I'm so sorry.
Sorry. But so this, and I guess his fleshlight, fuck the fleshlight.
Oh, yeah.
You use it as a jerk off.
You fuck it thing. Really good.
Yeah. Uh-huh. You bang it. Uh-huh. And this is like attached to the shower, and she takes a picture of it and then tweets it. This mom tweets it. And she's like, I don't know what my son is doing.
What kind of drugs is he inserting into his penis?
Yeah. And she's like, is this a new cleaning thing?
Oh, my God.
What is going on? And all the tweets are like, oh, your son's a freak. Oh. Your son is a pervert. And she's like, not my son. Like, she's responding to all the tweets. And like, it can't be that. There's no way he can fuck that.
Oh, brother.
But poor lady, like, what would you do? All right, let's say you had a kid. And what would you do if you saw him? Not perform, like, just imagine, like, catching somebody in the act of, like, performing sex on a fleshlight in a shower. Like, what do you do?
I would definitely look at myself and ask myself why I went into the bathroom having heard the shower running, first of all.
Sure.
Then I would consider investing in locks.
Right.
For my son's sake. And then I'd probably turn around and leave, because, like, everyone's got to get there. You got to get it out. You know, you got to get that nut sometimes,
yeah.
Dude.
No, I'm with it. I mean, the shower is a great place to, a private place where you can do your thing.
Do your business, you know.
But I don't know. If I were the kid, you know, he was getting a little too free with his.
Yeah, just leaving it posted up in the shower is kind of intense. Like,
yeah.
That's like a rig you want to build that's portable.
Yeah.
And easily collapsible.
You don't want to cart that one away.
Yeah, like.
At some point.
Even if you had your own private bathroom, like, what if you had a friend over there? Like, yeah. Dude, what the fuck, man?
Oh, forgot my fleshlight in the shower. Sorry, guys. But yeah, you want to take that down, at least put it under the sink or something.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it is, the coolest thing about it is that it looks like a flashlight.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
That's the point of it, is to be discreet.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, but think of it, it's like if a girl left a fucking, like, dildo, like, suction cup to the shower wall.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
it's the same shit.
Go ahead and use it, but, like, just put it away.
Put it away. It's simple.
Yeah.
Simple. Everyone's fine. Have you ever been caught by your parents?
Beating it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
A few times. Probably a couple times. And my roommate, I jerk off way too much.
Oh, no. I've definitely been caught, but, like, we both acknowledge that we should not speak of this.
This will never, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, my mom caught me once, and I, you know, I'm looking at the computer, doing my thing.
Oh, okay.
And she comes in behind me, and so it was kind of like a... I turn around. Like, you should not be in here right now.
Yes.
That's what knocking's for.
I'm
18 years old.
Get out of my room, Mom.
This is legal. You know, and I feel like I might have tried to be like, hey, so about earlier.
Yeah.
And it was just like, no, son, we're not doing that.
We're fine.
No.
We're all set here.
Yeah, I mean, if anyone thinks that their kid, like, doesn't fucking touch themselves, they're out of their minds. And if their kids don't touch themselves, like, maybe they should go see a doctor.
Yeah.
There might be a problem.
They're out of their minds. Yeah.
Unless you're super religious and, you know, like, I get it. Whatever
floats your boat,
mm-hmm.
You know?
I know Jesus will send you to hell if you touch yourself.
Mine was... See, I didn't have a TV or computer at a young age, so I had to be very imaginative.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was kind of, like, under the covers, like... And then, like, door
opens.
I'm glad
you're acting this out physically.
Yeah. But I'm saying, like, I just did, like, a Harlem shake.
By the way, for our listeners... It did not make sense. It was not what you would expect.
He's wiggling fish.
Yeah, he's like he's like jiggling his shoulders.
That's how I jerk off, guys. You gotta wiggle. No, but like door opens. Mom should knock. I think like 14 on, maybe 12 on. You need to be knocking.
Yeah, just in case. Like you don't know what's going on in there.
But like you know, door opens. We didn't have locks either on our doors. Door opens, and then there was just a lot of. Just like rustling, pulling the covers.
Yeah.
And it was just like, hey.
Hey, Mom, what's up?
Just saying goodnight. Okay, goodnight.
Boom. The end.
Yeah. Never spoken of.
Oh, that's not too bad.
Yeah,
I mean,
not too bad.
Yeah, that's better than like, oh, now my mom knows what my porn taste is. Possibly. I don't know how bad of a night that was. Yeah. I don't know what she saw. I don't remember. It could have been real dark.
This was my first time Googling gangbangs.
Yeah, I've never seen this before.
Now she thinks I love GBs.
Yeah, it's, ugh. It's
a, but yeah, it's poor a, mom. And lazy kid. You gotta fucking lock that up.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Finish your shit. Dude, Amazon drones.
What's up with them? Are they out yet?
I saw a video of a prototype today on some social media website. I don't fucking know.
Okay.
But, like, it looked really cool. It's just
how
like,
big are they?
They're, like, maybe the size of, like, a kitchen table.
Okay. Okay. Like, 3-4 feet in diameter.
Yeah.
Something like that.
And they're, like, super flat. They have the 4, like, rotating
okay.
propellers.
So they're kind of like the video drones, but they deliver shit is the
yeah.
idea. Okay.
And they have, like, in the middle of them, there's this kind of, like, apparatus that, like, clicks open and then the package goes in it.
Oh,
and then they have... They were showing these, like, almost like helipads in people's yards with the big Amazon logo on it. So, like, that's
wait,
where
wait,
they know.
So if you want to get Amazon instant delivery, you have to install a fucking helipad?
Yes.
I'm in.
Yes.
I'm 100% into this.
And people will do it. If you're fucking rich like that, you
yeah.
should be like, oh, yeah, honey, yeah, we got to put this big A in our backyard. And a lowercase a. I don't. I mean, we can write our son's name in it if you want.
Honey, I'm trying to get this tennis lesson. Okay, yeah. Like, you know, you cannot be asking me things while I'm getting my tennis lesson.
I mean, I'm a Prime member.
Oh, me too.
I'm a spoiled brat now because like I didn't think I needed it, but now I'm like. My package isn't here in 2.5 days.
Right.
What the fuck?
Yeah, anytime I order from not Amazon, any other seller, I'm like instantly pissed. Like, dude,
yeah.
1 week?
Yeah.
7 days? Are you kidding me?
What the fuck is going on with these guys?
Like, why am I buying shit from New Jersey? Fuck New Jersey.
These fucking jokers can't get me this package in a day.
When in reality it's because they don't have a warehouse like 20 minutes away.
Yeah, exactly. But these things, I mean... I don't know how they will get like the regulations in place to where they can just fly around.
Yeah, that's going to be interesting.
People are going to use the shit out of this.
Yeah, I think it'll be successful.
Yeah, but I mean a place like a gun-free like Arizona or Texas, and someone's going to be like, "Ain't no drone going to fly over my house,
dude."
And
then think about this though, like you're in Texas, you got a gun. And an Amazon drone flies by, and you shoot it down, and you go get the fucking loot.
Exactly.
Like, that sounds awesome.
Like, yeah.
Like, this is like some Fallout shit. Like, I want
to
do it.
What are you guys doing this weekend? You want to go to Arizona and shoot fucking Amazon drones?
Yeah. It's like it's like the Wild West, dude.
Yeah.
I love it.
Let's go get some loot. But like...
fucking fleshlight.
My poor fleshlight. Someone stole it.
I ordered this fleshlight 15 minutes ago, and that drone should have been here. What is going on? I'm trying to jerk off right now, and Maya just broke my fleshlight. Get it here. It came with free lube. I need
now,
that shit.
Now my mom's going to catch me in the fucking shower.
God
like
damn it.
Like an amateur.
She's going to be home in 20 minutes. I was supposed to get that in 15 minutes. Fuck.
But it's just, yeah, I think people are going to shoot them. I think they're going to, like, malfunction and fall on someone's car.
Yeah.
And then like
cut some kids' fucking faces up and
shit. Yeah. It's like the kid's gonna be like, yay, my soccer ball's here. Come here, drone. Land on the helipad. I'm dead. And then what is Amazon gonna do? What kind of insurance do they have?
You get like, free Amazon Prime for life. I think that's a win.
Dear Millers, very sorry for little Timmy's death. Here's Amazon Instant Video for 3 months.
Check out our new Oscar-winning or Emmy-winning show, Transparent.
Oh fuck,
jeez.
Yeah, so that's.
I'm real interested to see where that goes. It would be cool to see him flying around. It's kind of sketchy. I don't know. I don't even know how I totally feel about it.
It's
to be honest,
it's so weird.
It's like interesting, but I mean, it's better than driving around like expensive gas-guzzling trucks, I guess.
But then, like,
but how many packages can you hold with a single drone?
Yeah, it seemed like there was just one.
Yeah.
Like, I'll pull up. I have the video.
Okay, yeah, let me see that.
But yeah, it's fucking crazy. Like, look at that.
Oh, wow.
And, like, see the little package just, like, bloop.
I feel
see
like that's, yeah. I also feel like that's such a small.
And oh, there was her little helipad.
That's cool, but it's a movable helipad. Yeah. I was imagining like
you have to dedicate
like someone coming in here digging like a 3 foot hole, pouring concrete into it, like yeah. painting a fucking Amazon insignia on it.
Right. But yeah, you just kind of you take your Amazon A, you throw it in the yard. I mean, it looks cool. It looks efficient.
Yeah.
And it just drops it in your backyard where yeah. it sees the egg.
And it does look very specific, so like people will be able to know, like, oh, that's not terror.
That's not terror.
That's not terror. That's an Amazon drone.
But all someone has to do is just kind of capture that thing and, like, attach some fucking guns to it.
Ooh. I mean, the thing is, there's so many, like, video drones available now. Anyone can do that already. Yeah. Don't get any ideas, busters.
True. Great. We've talked about Saudi Arabia and then misusing drones.
We just got put on a list.
We're on a fucking list.
Great. We're not going to be able to fly for a while.
Uh-oh. We're on the goddamn list.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the drones are coming. How was your Thanksgiving?
It was good.
Yeah?
Yeah. It was quiet. I hung out with my very close family. Like, not the whole aunts, uncles, and grandparents thing. We did that a couple days later.
Right.
But just chilling with, like, my younger brothers and my mom and my stepdad and my stepbrothers and one of my stepbrother's kids and his wife or girlfriend. Not entirely sure what's going on.
Not sure.
Baby mama.
Fucking at least. Dragging yeah, his feet.
It was super chill. How was yours? What'd you do?
It was good. We went to Yucaipa.
Jenny. The fuck is Yucaipa?
Yucaipa. Jenny's mom, it's like 2 hours east of LA.
Okay.
Kind of the desert, like maybe a little south of Redlands.
Okay, nice. Yeah.
Like on the way to Coachella.
It's like San Bernardino.
Yeah, I think a little more east than that, though.
Okay. Okay.
But we did that. We ate some turkey, drank some burrs. But what I love is about Thanksgiving is the day after Black Friday.
Oh, yeah. What'd you get?
Fucking
you pick anything
love
up?
That shit, dude.
I had a terrible day on Black Friday. I'll tell you about it after yeah? you go, though. Yeah.
All right. Well, my favorite place to shop is always fucking Best Buy.
Oh, yeah.
Love Best Buy.
I saw fools camping out for Best Buy last week, like on Monday. And I
you
was like,
camped?
Oh, shit. No, I didn't. Oh. I saw some people doing it.
Dude, those campers.
Can't believe it.
But I got like FIFA 16.
Nice.
Brand new, like, soccer game. That's the shit. For like $25.
What?
Normally $60.
FIFA's really fun.
FIFA's
I might grab that so we can play.
It's really fun. I mean, even if you don't play soccer, it's just cool to like work the ball around and shoot.
I don't know anything about it, but I played FIFA and it's a blast.
Get it, dude. Mm-hmm. And then I got like a bunch of like badass Blu-rays for $9.
Sick.
This Black Friday is fun. It's cool.
Yeah.
I don't see it as like this monster of a day that we should all fight like other people.
Yeah, that's the part of it that I don't like is just how like insane people get over it. Like it should just be an opportunity to like grab some cool stuff, like do your Christmas shopping.
Get your deals.
But like it's become this like just like insane cultural event and
you
know, there's just people are just crazy and so, you know, weirdos are going to go and make it way more intense than it needs to be.
There's always going to be that fucker who's like I'm getting 6 TVs, goddammit.
Yeah, and then I'm going to sell them or I don't know what I'm going to do with 16 TVs, but he's going to do it.
I think that's what the campers do.
Yeah.
They camp and they get like 4 TVs or like 5 cameras and then they flip them.
Yeah.
Those are like the in it for the business type people. But someone like me is like, dude, I just want to get some Blu-rays and a video game.
Yeah.
Fuck
yeah.
It's not
almost
a big deal.
I wanted to get a PlayStation during Black Friday,
mm-hmm.
but everyone started talking about playing Battlefront, so
oh, yeah,
I got it early.
Yeah.
So I didn't really have anything I wanted to get.
Yeah, you gotta get that shit.
Yeah.
But and then the argument is like, well, it takes away from their families and blah blah blah, and they can't celebrate Thanksgiving. Well, I was talking to Jenny about it. It's like, dude,
I don't chill with my family on Friday.
Yeah,
after Thanksgiving.
But some people don't celebrate Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Some people hate Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Some people's families were murdered on Thanksgiving and they would wish to never look at Thanksgiving again.
Exactly.
They'd be like, I want to work.
Statistically speaking, absolutely.
Yeah. And then there's people who are like, dude, I'm making time and a half.
Yeah.
Fuck this.
Yeah. I'd be down to work a holiday like that for sure.
Like, we're going to work Thanksgiving and have our Thanksgiving on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't see a problem with that.
Well, I mean, I think working on Thanksgiving Day kind of blows. Like, if you have the option to work on Thanksgiving and you take it, that's one thing.
Yeah.
But, like, I'd be upset. I thought you were talking about Black Friday. Fuck Black Friday. I think everyone should fucking work on Black Friday. Suck my dick.
Well, I mean, yeah, like, a lot of stores, they'll open at, like, 7 p.m. on Thanksgiving Day.
Oh, so that's what people are tripping on when they're talking about opening on Thanksgiving, then.
Right.
I see.
But in doing so, you break up those crazy people at midnight who are trampling people.
Yeah.
You know? You allow them to come in, like, during the day of Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And, I mean, what the fuck is Thanksgiving anyway, if you really want to...
I mean, if you really think about it, it's pretty much the worst holiday that we have. It's pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
It's pretty backwards.
It's total shit.
Yeah, like, hey, remember 200 or 500 years ago when, like, you motherfuckers came over here and gave us blankets full of fucking smallpox?
And slaughtered our families?
After we gave you a really cool-looking cornucopia with, like, fruits and corn in it that had different color kernels?
You give us...
Assholes?
You give us white disease.
Yeah.
And steal our land and celebrate it.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving.
And then put us in shitty wood cabins on fucking Grand Canyon.
Shitty reservations. Now we all have hepatitis.
Yeah. And we're all alcoholics because, like, you fucking white people talk so fucking much. We have to drink to, like, be able to hang, you fucking assholes. Or something. I assume that's why they drink. I don't know.
Easy ride. Down, boy. So what was your Black Friday like?
You know, I said it was bad. It wasn't. The next day was bad. Saturday was bad. Oh. I didn't really do anything on Black Friday. I think I was hanging out with my girlfriend. What up? What up, Samantha?
What's up, boo-boo?
What's up, girl? Saturday kind of blew because I forgot that it was still kind of Black Friday weekend.
Right.
It's still kind of crazy. So I was just trying to go out and, like, I'll just walk around and, like, go to Burbank and shit. But, like, there was nowhere to park and it was crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And sometimes when I'm around a lot of people, I just get kind of anxious. So I was dealing with that. And then as I'm leaving, I, like, backed into somebody's car.
Oh, no.
This is fucking bullshit.
What did you do? Did you leave a note?
No. I talked to her. She was there. We exchanged things. It was really chill.
Is she going through insurance?
Yeah, I told her to. I was like, I'm going to report this. You report it. It's all good. My bad. It wasn't a lot of damage.
Yeah.
So it's fine.
You could be a dick and report it and be like, this bitch rear-ended me.
It's very clear that she did not rear-end me because I, like, backed into the back of her, like, driver's side of her car.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's clearly my fault.
Damn, yeah. That sucks.
It was a bummer. But what are you going to do?
What are you going to do, man? Shit happens.
Exactly.
I've never been in a... Have you ever been in a big-ass accident?
I haven't been. I've been in, like, a small to medium-sized accident.
Word.
No biggie. Hurt my back a little bit.
I've had dreams I've been in big accidents.
It's a scary thought, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I think my dream... Me dreaming it will help me when I'm... If it happens.
Be prepared for it.
Yeah, I really do.
Have you known anyone who's been in a gnarly accident?
Yeah, I think so. One of my aunts, like, rolled her van.
Oh, fuck.
Weren't you with somebody who ran over a person?
Oh, fuck, yeah.
Oh, that's gnarly.
That's
a friend of mine did that.
Big accident.
Tell me about that, if you want to.
At Frostburg, me and this guy... We were leaving, me, this guy, and a couple other dudes, we were leaving this bar, Repub. Back in the day, it was called the Republican Club.
Okay.
But like, all the kids call it Repub.
They would. I'm surprised this was not at Silver Lake.
Yeah, so it's like, you going to pub? And like, yeah, sure. So we're leaving pub, and we get in the car, we're like, bad as shit. We're like, yeah, turn up the music, bro. We turn it up. We start going, and then you hear the worst noise I've ever heard in my life,
fuck.
Which was... And I was like, what the fuck just happened? I'm in the back seat, and I was like, dude, what did you do? What happened?
Did you see any of that go down? Like, did you see this dude or woman's body?
Out of the corner of my eye, I just saw, like, an object, like, come up on the windshield and, like, off to the side. But... She went to the hospital. She lived. The driver got a DUI.
Oh.
And arrested. But she was jaywalking.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Interesting.
So, like, that kind of... that kind of canceled it out as far as
so he didn't get any vehicular manslaughter stuff. Yeah, I guess you only get charged that if you actually killed the person, right?
Yeah. But that was pretty scary. But it was like we weren't even going that fast.
Yeah.
And I bet she probably left the bar too. So yeah, I bet her being, you know, like they say, like if you're in a skiing accident and you're falling, you should just go jelly.
Yeah.
And
let it loosen up so you don't like.
Yeah. I think her being drunk helped her because she didn't like clench up.
Right.
Yeah.
Did you ever do any extreme sports when you were young? Snowboarding,
skateboarding? Snowboarded.
Yeah.
Yep.
That wrestling. Always would help when you'd fall.
Yeah.
Like I'd always roll onto like my side and like let my wrist be really limp.
There you go.
I don't know why I was looking at Jenny. Like she would understand what that meant. Like, you know like, Jenny, limp wrist.
You know.
I got that.
Yeah, she's. Oh yeah, there. Yeah, she knows.
Your wrist.
That sounds gnarly, though, man. I had a friend.
It was scary.
Who got in a small accident, and pulled over with the guy he got in the accident with, and the other guy got out of his car and they went to discuss, you know, exchanging information. And as the guy walked back to his door, he got just murdered by a car. Just,
what?
Done. Just yeah.
He died.
Yeah. Just died instantly. Holy and then shit. The dude's wife tried to blame that on my friend for causing the initial tiny accident.
No.
Yeah, which doesn't fly.
That didn't stick,
yeah, it was
did it?
But just him having to deal, like he had to go to court for that because she pressed those charges. So he like got tried for murder almost. And it was really a really fucked up situation. Yeah, poor guy.
Yeah, they say really, never. If you get hit and you pull over, get away.
Yeah,
and like exit your car and like go somewhere.
Yeah, unless there's no option to, and like,
yeah,
I don't even know what to do then. Don't get in accidents on the freeway.
Yeah,
pretty gnarly.
So you can still donate after Movember's over, but we went to this badass party. See, what y'all don't know about Movember is awesome. If you at the end of November, you get invited to this party that's on Santa Monica Pier if you live in LA. And they have these parties all over the place to celebrate Movember and promote men's health and wellness.
Right.
Not only is it about testicular cancer and prostate cancer, it is about promoting men's health and like ending like inactivity in men and shit like that.
Nice. Okay. So that's really cool.
What is it? What is Movember for people who don't know?
For jerks who don't fucking know, I've been trying to push this shit on you all month, but you grow a mustache from scratch.
You have to shave at the beginning of November, right?
Yeah. There's a shave the date.
Shave the date, it's called. Of course it is.
on October 31st, you shave the date and you shave it down. And then you grow it in hopes that people, like, because the mustache isn't, like, a thing. Like, I mean, not every day you see somebody with a straight-up stash, you know?
At least not somebody who looks normal.
Right. But that's...
most of the time.
That helps, that, like, ignites the conversation. Like, people are like, oh, so why are you wearing that mustache? Or, hey, you look like a child molester. Or... wow, you really look like a cop.
Funny you should mention child molesting. Do you know about ass cancer?
But, like, that's funny, but that is it. That is Movember, because you initiate the conversation with how odd you look, because you don't normally grow a mustache, and then you're like, boom, here is this great cause that I'm in.
Yeah, let's save some testicles, let's save some assholes.
Yeah.
I love it.
Give me a dollar.
Not like assholes as in the colloquialism for a jerk.
Right.
But like literal, like an asshole, like an anus.
A butthole.
Like a chocolate starfish.
Yes. A balloon tip.
A balloon tip is one of those? Oh, it is, isn't it? I just saw it. I just visualized it.
A balloon knot.
Balloon knot.
Sorry, Jenny.
Okay.
Jenny is an expert.
Jenny's an asshole expert.
On asshole terms.
No, I'm not. I just heard it.
Apologies to the chef. Sorry. My B. What's up, Jordan? Jordan loves the Gremlins. But, yeah, so you go to this party. It's awesome. It's $20. It wasn't $20 last year. If you... what's the word? If you collected over $200. You got a free ticket.
Oh, sick.
And then you could drink all you want. But it all, that year, it was only like Schlitz beer.
Hey, Schlitz is pretty good. They have that at the Griffin over in Glendale. I'm for it.
Schlitz.
Really high in alcohol.
Schlitz is it's high? Fucking toxic. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's like it's malt. I had like malt two beverage. And I was wasted.
Yeah, that's beverage. My. Oh, yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Two and I'm wasted.
Not into it.
It's my middle name, Ryan. Two and I'm wasted. Albertson.
Two and I'm wasted.
Well, that's cool. How was the party? Like, what are there activities and stuff?
Yeah,
what kind of people are there?
Band. They had a live band. They have a costume contest. They have, you know, you can shoot hoops. They got the little ring tossy thing on the string.
What's up? They got beer pong? They got to have beer pong.
They had bucket beer pong.
What?
With trash cans.
Oh, that's awesome.
And you, like, you shoved up like
basketballs.
A volleyball.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
So that was dope. Fun. And it was just really, really fun. It was good times. We got drunk. And then we came home.
So how do I get a ticket next year? Do I have to do a team and raise $200?
You can join my team. You can make your own team. You can be a loner. But Movember's the shit, y'all. It's very, very cool.
You totally invited me to join your team this year, and I'm such a piece of shit that I was like, yeah, tight.
Never
fucking did it.
You are a fucking jerk.
You sent me an email request, and I was like, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you sent me a text, and I was like, sweet, thanks. And then I'm just such an asshole.
Then absolutely nothing. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna
don't be like me. Do as I say, not as I do, listeners.
I'm gonna make you watch Man Camp starring Dean Cain.
Guess what? Already seen it.
Man Camp? All right, let's just name Dean Cain fucking movies.
I'm into this.
Airplane vs. Volcano. Dean Cain plays Rick Pierce in Airplane vs. Volcano.
Dean Cain. Who plays the volcano?
All right, how about Sheriff Rick Langston in Small Town Santa?
Oh, boy. Do you think he plays the Santa or the sheriff who, like, arrests the pervert Santa? Well, that's how I would have written it, the sheriff that arrests the pervert Santa.
Well, he's listed as Sheriff Rick Langston, so I think he's the sheriff.
Oh, yeah, right. I heard that. I did not acknowledge it.
Yeah. Oh, Dean Cain stars as Glenn Barrows in A Bell for Christmas.
He loves Christmas. This man loves Christmas. Him. This man loves Christmas.
Or how about this role? Kent Walsh is Dean Cain in A Horse for Summer.
Oh, a summer movie. Mm-hmm. Summer flick. He's mixing it up here.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck is A Horse for Summer about? What? Read that synopsis to me. I want to, like, what?
Kent Walsh. All right, A Horse for Summer. Oh, God. When a family emergency forces a troubled teen to do the wrong thing for the right reason, a community discovers the meaning of forgiveness.
First Dean of all, Cain what is a wrong thing that can be done for a right reason? That's something I'm really curious about.
I don't know
about.
You.
Steal for children who don't have any food.
Are you sure the reason isn't love and the wrong thing isn't sex?
Like John, because
that's what I assume.
I assume some sort of John Q scenario
where
I hold up a hospital hostage to give my son a heart. Because
you motherfuckers won't give me my son a fucking heart.
My son needs a heart. Now I'm gonna stay here.
Haven't seen that movie. I gotta see that.
Oh, dude. I cried.
Ooh, I just suddenly got a real strong urge to do, like, a Denzel fest. I haven't seen a Denzel movie in a while.
Denzel's funny you should mention that.
What? Are you fucking kidding me?
Dean Cain,
are you serious right now? This was not planned, people, I promise you.
Dean Cain stars co-side with Denzel Washington in the 2003 crime drama thriller Out of Time.
What?
You can watch.
Beside, he co-stars? Like, he has a more than small role in it?
Oh, yeah.
More than day player status?
He is fourth in the billing.
Oh, shit.
As Chris Harrison.
That would be a great movie for Doug Benson's show.
A Florida police chief must solve a vicious double homicide before he himself falls under suspicion. Let's play a little game.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you the name of a Dean Cain movie. You're going to tell me the plot, okay?
Oh, my pleasure.
And we'll see if you're right. Okay.
Can we bet?
Airplane.
Because everyone should be betting against me.
Airplane versus Volcano. Go.
Okay, so Dean Cain, tell me his character's name.
Okay. Dean Cain's name is Rick Pierce.
So Rick Pierce was a boxer, you know, he's down, but he's down and out. He used to have a really good career. Sure. Not quite as good as Rocky, kind of like a mid-level, like he's like got a 60% win rate, you know, but he's aging. He's aging out. He's about 80. Okay. And so he just can't box anymore.
Done boxing.
But he's also Hawaiian, and it turns out that a Hawaiian volcano by the name of, we're going to record this later,
Rick
Mike,
Pierce.
Will you insert the name of the volcano that I'm going to tell you after this, because we're going to record that?
Vesuvius.
Excellent. Yeah, so he fights that volcano that I just named the actual name of, and wins. That's the plot of the movie.
That's the plot?
That's
Hawaiian boxer, down on his luck, fights a volcano.
Has to go fight a volcano. Oh, to save his estranged dog's great-grand dog.
Okay.
Because he loves animals.
Well, you're wrong.
Bullshit. You're fucking cheating.
When a commercial airliner is trapped within a ring of erupting volcanoes, the passengers and crew must find a way to survive without landing. But when the relentless onslaught of lava and ash causes fear and distrust amongst those on board, it isn't just the volcanoes that are life-threatening.
So the dust and the volcano ash are the things that cause the fear and distrust and not people's fucking insane minds. I like that.
Everyone must learn to work together if they are to survive the epic Flight of Fire.
Flight of Fire? Why is this movie, first of all, not called fucking Flight of Fire? Jesus.
They got lazy.
Oh my God.
It's Airplane versus Volcano.
Airplane versus Volcano.
Okay. How about Dean Cain as Robert in Kill Katie Malone?
Oh, this is actually
a horror thriller.
This is actually about my dad, Robert.
This is a documentary?
Yeah, this is a documentary film about my father, who was accused of killing Katie Malone.
Ah.
That was when I was about 7, personally, when I was living in Acton.
Okay.
For those of you who haven't heard of Acton, it's not even a suburb outside of L.A.
Acton.
So this girl was missing for about 8 years, and it turns out that they found her in a truck, like up by a big water basin, and she said, "Like, dude, Robert did it." He was kidnapping me and stuff for like 7 years straight, kidnapping me. And yeah, so the cops went after him. You know, they came to our house. It was real scary.
This is real.
And but it turned out that Cody, your co-host, actually killed her, which they just found out. Which
Cody
is actually,
Fred?
Which is actually why Friedrich's not on the podcast today. So this is
running from the law.
The official announcement of his
Cody's a
running
murderer
from the law.
Well, college students and best friend Ginger Matheson, Jim Duncan, and Kyle Dixie Canning.
What man's fucking nickname is Dixie? First of all,
Kyle Dixie Canning. Hey, Kyle. It's probably like the first grade, like, hey, Kyle. Hey, man. What are you drinking out of? A Dixie cup. I'm going to call you Dixie. Something dumb like that.
I agree.
They pull their cash.
Or he's always getting Dixie in the public pool, if you know what I'm saying.
They pull their cash to buy a ghost in an online auction.
To buy a ghost from an auction?
Yes.
What the fuck is happening?
Ginger Matheson, Jim Duncan, and Kyle Dixie Canning pool their cash to buy a ghost in an online auction. The three think it's all a goof, but once they open up the antique box to examine their treasure,
bing bong, it's a real ghost.
They unleash the vengeful spirit of an Irish servant girl who has been wreaking havoc on her owners throughout the generations. Boom.
Oh my god, I need to see that movie.
Is that available on Amazon Prime? Because I want to watch it right now.
The full, it says synopsis warning contains spoilers. I will not read Alan in case anyone wants to watch that movie.
Oh, thank you.
But I'm going to add it to my watch list, but it is not available. You're going to have to buy that one. Let's do one more.
All right, all right.
I'm going to find a good one. I'm going to find a good one. Okay. Do, 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 do. Oh, yes. This is a TV movie in 2003. Dean Cain plays Jack Wedlow.
What up, Jack Wedlow?
In Gentle Ben 2, Danger on the Mountain.
Oh, Gentle Ben 2, Danger on the Mountain. So this is actually a follow-up to 1987's Gentle Ben 1,
right.
Gentle Woman on the Mountain. In which Ben goes up Mount Whitney because he's training to be a strong man, and yes. So as he's hiking on Mount Whitney, he meets this woman who's just like, she's got really soft hands, and she just touches him all the time, and she's like touching him all the time, and it's really gentle, and that's the end of the first one. And a lot of people were really disappointed in that plot because they were like, oh, I didn't think this was going to be an art film. Like, I thought there was going to be, like, some actual stuff happening here.
Right.
So the studio was like, all right, let's, they're right. You we'll know, we got to give the people what they want.
Yeah.
And so they got the writing going on the next one, Gentle Ben 2,
Danger on
the Mountain.
Yeah.
In which, you know, we cut right back to, you know, the gentlewoman on the mountain.
Right.
She's petting him. And it turns out that she actually is poison.
She's the danger.
She's the danger. Like, oh. She's poisonous, and she's been touching him the whole time.
Right.
And so he has to climb to the top of the mountain, where there's a secret crystal buried under some snow. And he has to dig through the snow before the poison gets to his heart. Ooh. Because then he can never love again.
So it's a race against time. Romance drama.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
I will see that.
It's really good. It's dark. It's got some humor, but
sure. Yeah. There's a big struggle there between love and
you're really going to feel the full spectrum of emotions while you're watching it. I can guarantee you that.
Okay. Here's the synopsis. With tensions running high between Jack and Fogg over plans to drill on his land, there's a person named Fogg in this movie. That isn't missed, okay? All right. With tensions running high between Jack and Fogg over plans to drill on his land that abuts the wilderness preserve, Fogg announces to the whole town that he isn't drilling for oil, but is opening a natural spring water business. Jack doesn't believe him, and the night of the big announcement, he is jailed, suspected of sabotaging Fogg's well. But Ben and Mark soon uncover a secret that Fogg's business partners aren't telling him about. In fact, this new venture turns out to be more than Fogg could have bargained for. It's a race to prove Jack's innocence and uncover the truth before Mark is taken back to the city to live in a foster home.
Wah, wah.
What? I liked your plot much better. I don't even know what I just read.
I really want to watch a trailer for that, and I just want it to be like Trailer Voice Man reading that synopsis over it. Because I'd have no idea what happened in that movie.
With tensions and that's what I like. Between Jack and Fogg. Oh, God.
Do, do, do.
Do, 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 do. Again, Ryan, I want to thank you for covering for Cody here.
My pleasure. I'm sorry I wasn't here. Cody, I love you, bud.
We love you, buddy.
How you doing, bud? I hope you're feeling better.
This was dope. This was fun. Everybody, listen to Lois and Clarked. Just dropped this week.
Find us on iTunes. We have a SoundCloud as well. There'll be links in the notes of this show, I assume.
We'll drop mad links. Starring Matt Truex. What's up, Matt?
Matt Truix. Yeah, he's our my wonderful co-host. He's seriously fucking amazing.
Yeah.
That podcast would be nothing without him, literally.
Sorry we laid it on really thick, Dean Cain.
Yeah.
My bad.
We had a good time, though. I needed to get that out personally.
Yeah, just... Hey, yeah, it's all love on your podcast.
Absolutely. But and the truth is, like, I do really enjoy it, and I do really enjoy him. So, you know,
good.
It's out of respect.
Well, you better, because you have seasons of
There's a long way to go. Oh, there's a long way to go.
Have you ever heard of the term Stockholm Syndrome?
Yes. And you have Terry Hatcher's boobs to keep you company.
Oh, yeah, that sustains. The last episode we watched, there was, like, a love potion, and she was like, oh, man, was real... It got her. It got her good. And she got me good. You know
she
what I'm saying?
She got you good. Hit your fleshlight in the shower after that one, huh?
That was exactly where I was going with that.
Thanks for listening, y'all.
Yeah, thanks
Lois
for having
and
me,
Clark.
Man.
Listen. Peace.
Ain't nobody playing itself down to shit, all right?